नहीं नहीं अभी तक नहीं, जस्ट
Mr. Babu, my voice, is it audible?
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, very good morning to all. Welcome to our webinar on the webinar. I am Mr. Babu, yes,
Hello, Gopi. சான்ஸ் யார் ஸ்டார்ட் பண்றாங்க Gopi? Hello? Anita?
Ha, ma'am, shall I start? I'm not getting
you. Yes, yes, Anita, you please start.
Yeah, I am starting, ma'am.
Anita, you start, Anita.
Yeah. Very good adverb morning to one and all present in this webinar. I, Ms. Anita Nandi, Vice Principal, Apex College of Nursing, Varanasi, is my privilege and pleasure on behalf of Apex College of Nursing to welcome you all in this session. First of all, I would like to welcome to our today's honorable chief guest, Padma Shri Dr. Saro Chudamani Gopal Ma'am, President, National Academy of Medical Sciences, former Vice Chancellor, King George Medical University, Lucknow. About the madam, madam was born on 25th July 1944 in our holy city, Varanasi. After schooling, madam has chosen a career in medicine, graduated from the Sarojini Naidu Medical College, Agra in 1966 and did her MS at the same college in 1969. This was followed by securing MCH in pediatric surgery from All India Institute of Medical Science, New Delhi in 1973. Madam is the first woman pediatric surgeon in the country. Madam started her career by joining the faculty of the Institute of Medical Sciences, BHU, in 1973, where she worked till her retirement in 2008 as the medical superintendent of the Medical College Hospital and as the dean of the Faculty of Medicine. In the same year, Madam has selected as the vice chancellor of the King George's Medical University, Lucknow, becoming the first woman to head the university, and from there she has retired in 2011. Madam has published several articles in peer-reviewed national and international journals. Some of her articles on hemangioma and teratoma have provided valuable insights on the treatment of the diseases. Madam holds various positions like honorary professor of the Center of Biomedical Research. She was the president of the Indian Association of Pediatric Surgeons since 1998. She has been a member of the expert panel of the National Academy of Medical Sciences, New Delhi, and examined with many universities, and also an inspector of the UGC. She's also a member of professional bodies like the Association of Surgeons of India, IEM, and the Indian Academy of Medical Sciences. Madam is a recipient of many honors, such as Commonwealth Medical Scholarship, Indo-German Fellowship, Indo-Finnish Fellowship, etc. Madam has received the President's Medal in 1966, Sushila Nair Shield for Excellence in Studies. The Government of India conferred the Dr. B.C. Roy Award, Madam, in 2002. Dr. Mridula Rohtagi Oration Award of the Association of Pediatric Surgeons of India in 2005, and Colonel Sangram Lal Oration Award of Indian National Medical Academy in 2007. Madam is honored by the Government of India in 2013 by bestowing on her the Padma Shri, the fourth highest civilian award for her contribution in the medicine and the medical education. I welcome you, ma'am. Next, I would like to welcome to our today's guest of honor, to Dr. Judith Ariyappan, HOD of Maternal and Childhood Department, College of Nursing, Sultan Qaboos University, Muscat, Oman. Madam is an eminent personality in our nursing field. She's having 23 years of the professional experience in nursing field and holds many association members of the many associations like editorial board member in the Journal of Nursing and Practice, International Journal of Pediatric Nursing, Chief of Editor in Chief of Research and Review Journal of Nursing and Health Sciences, Editorial Board Member in Journal of Comprehensive Nursing Research and Care since 2017. Ma'am received various grants like grants from ICMR for a conference and on creating awareness of nurses and general public towards organ donation in 2012 and creating awareness of nurses on evidence-based practice in nursing in 2014. I extend a favorable welcome to you, ma'am. Now, I would like to welcome to our today's special guest, Dr. Leslie Prabha Bhalsaraj, ma'am, HOD, Community and Mental Health Department, Sultan Qaboos University, Muscat, Oman. As madam has accepted as a special guest, madam too is an eminent personality in our nursing field. She is having more than 33 years of teaching experience and 15 years experience after PhD. Madam has published more than 100 research articles and an important resource persons in various national and international conferences and seminars. I welcome you, ma'am. Next, I would like to welcome to our chairman, sir, of Apex Hospital, Dr. S.K. Singh, who is such an inspiring personality and encourage us to do this kind of activities. I welcome you, sir. Next, I extend my welcome to Dr. Saroop Patel, Director, Apex Hospital, for his support in every activity in our institution. I welcome you, sir. Now, I would like to welcome to Dr. Ankita Patel, Director, Apex Hospital, who always helping us for success of any event in our Apex family. I welcome you, ma'am. Next, I would like to welcome our beloved principal, ma'am, Professor R. John Sirani, without whose support this event, any event cannot be successful. I welcome you, ma'am. Now I extend my gratitude to Mr. Sanjeev Sharma, Public Relations Manager, who always help us to conduct any event in our institution. I welcome you, sir. Next, I'd welcome Mr. Gopi, sir, in charge principal at Apex Nursing College, whose contribution is so much in this meeting, in this webinar. I also welcome to Mr. Gaurav Singh, associate professor and the faculties in the nursing colleges and obviously my dear students who are participated in this webinar. Once again, I welcome you all in this webinar session. Thank
Gopi? Gopi?
Yes, thank you, ma'am. Next, okay. I would like to request all the dignitaries for the today's program. First, I want to introduce Chief Guest Padma Shri, Dr. S. Churumani Gopal, President, National Academy of Medical Science, India, former Vice Chancellor of King George Medical University, Lucknow. Welcome you, ma'am.
Thank you.
So I request ma'am to say a few words on this occasion for Women's Health Day.
Thank you very much. The chief director and the organizing chairman of this lab seminar, Dr. S.K. Singh, CEO of Apex Group of Higher Medical Education Institutes, the special guest of Dr. The guest of honor, Dr. Judy Arulappan from Sultan Qaboos University of Medical College of Nursing, Muscat, Oman. The special guest, Dr. Belsi Prabha Bhalsaraj from the same institution as head of Department of community and mental health. Then the director of this institution, Apex Institution, Dr. Swarup Patel, Dr. Ankita Patel, the director of super specialties, the principal of nursing college, Apex Nursing College, John Sireni, the faculty from this nursing college, Apex Nursing College, Anita Nandi, vice principal, Ms. Anshi, Shrija Nair, Shirish, the participants for this webinar, students and guests. Welcome to this webinar on a very, very special subject, very important for women, our health, our rights, our lives, women health matters. On this International Day of Action for Women's Health, 28th May, dedicated for observance of action for women's health, being observed regularly from the year 1987, an initiative taken by International Women's Health Group at Costa Rica, Latin America, and Caribbean Women's Health Network. And then, ever since this has been regularly organized on 28th of May, focusing the whole world's attention to planning better health for women. And ever since it is partnership in this endeavor is growing richer every day, at least by now, more than 125 countries have joined this mission. The mission is to empower, encourage, emancipate, celebrate, and commit with resolve for a social, economic, political, cultural, economic, and better health for women. Women's health in India has been something the Indian government as well as social organizations have been actively taking part in improving it. And no doubt that with time, things are becoming better. But still, there is not more to be done. Women still face heavy gender bias. They face malnutrition, lack of basic sanitation, dearth of healthcare, and resource utilization in Africa. Even in things like vaccination, when the nation is getting vaccination from the government, it must pay for all. Still, particularly in rural areas, one would find that the girl child is not given importance even for vaccination. Malnutrition prevails, especially in adolescent girls and in young ladies. Maternal health care is also suffering, leading to still high mortality rates in our Indian women. This is more evident in women from rural areas, where the mortality rate is almost 132% times as compared to urban areas. The gender inequality index of India, among all the nations, among the 187 nations that were analyzed in 2011, India ranked at 132. So this means we still have a lot more to achieve and a lot more to go. Urban versus rural health, medical, maternal mortality rate among rural areas in the women is very high. The Indian government has established a special national commission for women, which tries to look into where it can improve upon the things. Then there is National Rural Health Mission. Ever since it has come up, the statistics, health statistics have started improving. Yet, there is a lot to be done. In cases of disease like HIV and AIDS, women do not get the equal importance. Mental health, particularly, women are still worse sufferers. The suicide rate in women is high. The domestic violence is perpetual. And these are the issues where national and international bodies have to concentrate their efforts to bring them down. Organizing this important web seminar, I'm sure will take us, will help us in streamlining and taking actions, and actions at governmental as well as non-governmental level. That such a great endeavor is taken by this Institute of Apex Institute of Education. I'm sure these deliberations will bring fruitful results in future. All the best for this endeavor. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am. So kind of your informations, which is needed today's society. So next, I would like to call upon Dr. Judy Arulappam, Assistant Professor, College of Nursing, Sultan Qaboos University, Muscat, Oman, to share few words on this occasion.
Happy morning, everybody. Hope I am audible to everyone.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. So, whether my face is visible?
No, ma'am. Something is a blur.
I don't know. During my presentation, I will try to rectify. I do not know. There is some issue with the video. So I thank, at the outset, I thank the chairman, the organizing chairperson, the program coordinator, and principal, Ms. Johnsy, and Gopi, for everybody for organizing this webinar. And really, I'm very much delighted to be here today because I could see Padma Shri Churamani Gopal being a Padma Shri, a recipient of a Padma Shri award. So I'm really happy to see you, ma'am. Really, we are blessed to see you today and being with you today. And thank you very much, the management as well as Ms. Jansi, for giving the opportunity. I don't want to take much of the time because already Dr. Churamani has highlighted about the theme of the webinar. So only thing I wish to say, being a woman, I am really blessed to be born as a woman and as a female. When I was looking at the synonyms of female, I was really happy to see the words like womanhood, feminine, motherhood, girl, soft, delicate, gentle, tender, graceful, refined, modest, girly, feminine, womanly, ladylike. What a wonderful terms a woman has. So this itself is making me so happy and excited that I am born as a woman. So with this brief note, I will conclude and I will continue with my session in the next few minutes. Okay. Thank you again for the opportunity.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. So much of thank you. The next I would like to call Dr. Blessy Prabha Valsaraj, HOD, Community and Mental Health Department, College of Nursing, Sultan Qaboos University, Oman, to say a few words on this Women's Health Day, ma'am.
Pleasant morning to everybody. And I really proud to be part of this honorable gathering. And at the outset, I thank the esteemed organizers and my dear friend, Dr. Judy, who referred me to this, to the principal, Ms. Jansi. I'm delighted to be part of this event with extinguished guests like Padma Shri, Dr. S. Churamani, and other honorable guests. And I, like Dr. Judy shared, this is a blessed event, blessed time to be with you to share a few thoughts on women's rights and women's, especially my area is mental health. So to highlight a few things before we start into the actual deliberations, mental health of a woman or womanhood and mental health, is it a concern? Definitely it is a concern because women are the creator of society in its true sense. Are our women mentally healthy? This is a question to be asked to ourselves and to the society at a stretch as a whole. So according to National Institute of Mental Health in 2017, 46.6 million adults in US were treated for mental illness. So in US, why are we comparing with US? Maybe the awareness is more and people come forward with less stigma even then. there were 20% of the adult population were treated for a given mental illness, and yet the percentage of women being treated for mental illness was almost 50% higher than the percentage of men. So women's mental health, the facts, if we just quickly go through, women are twice likely as men to be impacted with generalized anxiety disorder. So all the anxiety disorders, the rates are much higher. Women are also twice likely as men to be diagnosed with panic disorder. And prevalence of serious mental illness is almost 70% greater in women compared to men. And exposure to violence are, as already the chief guest mentioned, we all know they are more prone maybe with the gentleness. There are certain qualities, but they can be at disadvantages to at certain situations to some extent. Then certain personality disorders, which will put them in a trap in almost all the situations, because it is their own make which they don't identify, like borderline personality disorder, sometimes a chronic low self-esteem related to body image. Then the hormonal and physical factors like menstruation and other factors like pregnancy related postpartum depression, perimenopausal symptoms or premenstrual dysphoric disorders, all these put the women at risk compared to men to have some mental adjustment problems. Though we are strong, yes, we are strong, but we need to recognize the strength within us. Then only we can share our wisdom to the family and to the society. So this is the right kind of awareness in the right time, I would say. There are certain differences between the mental health and of men and women also, because men always come forward when they are affected to some certain extent. They are not that stigmatized, whereas women, there is an internal self stigma. They think that it is shame to share their concerns, so they don't disclose. So subsequently, as the result, they suffer within themselves. So they may not be able to utilize their true potentials. So in our today's discussion, let us discuss more about the strategies. Later part, I will share some of the tips that women can utilize always as handy. Thank you so much for this opportunity and for inviting me as a special guest as well as a resource person. Thank you. That's it.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes.
Next, I would like to show some video presentation on this Women's Day. Thank you. This is dedicated to all the women, which is prepared by Ms. Anushi, one of our faculty. So next, I would like to request Dr. Judy Arlappam, ma'am. Hello.
Yes, please.
Ma'am, you can present your session, ma'am.
Yeah, I will start. I'm not able to share my screen. Can you enable it?
Yes, ma'am. Your video is enabled only.
No, my audio. My screen. Can you enable my screen? Host disabled participant screen sharing, it comes.
Okay, I'll stop sharing.
I'm unable to, show my screen. Okay, fine. Is it visible now? Is my screen can you see my screen?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Please proceed, ma'am.
Okay, fine. So, okay, fine. Thank you again for inviting me for this webinar. I'm really happy to see the title of the webinar, Our Health, Our Rights, Our Lives, Women's Health Matters. It is really interesting to see this title. We are responsible for our health and we should know our rights and we should know how to live our lives. And of course, women's health matters because we are the creator, as Dr. Blessy rightly mentioned, we are the creators of the, creators. So with this note, I would like to start my presentation. So I feel that all of us are proud to be a woman. So nobody would say that you're not feeling proud to be a woman, but I personally feel that I'm proud to be a woman because everyone starts off as females in the uterus. Maybe all of you know about this fact. So when we are created in the uterus, we are developing as, so initially the blueprint is a female blueprint. So from 60th day only, the embryos with Y chromosome gets converted to male. So that means the creation itself is starting with the female blueprint. So we should be really happy that we are female blueprint. And some of the history's most impressive figures were women, like Queen Elizabeth, Queen Victoria, Cleopatra, and many people. So that also makes us feel so proud that we are women. And women have always worked hard. So all of you know that we are multitasking. We are very talented. And men do not get offended, but it is a fact. So women are multitasking and we are really talented and we can do many tasks at a point of time. So this is a proven fact. And men have something called as nothing box, they can work at only one concept at a point of time. However, women can do many tasks at the same point of time. You would have realized it in your day-to-day life. Say, for example, when you're working in the kitchen, so at the same time, we will be able to take care of all the other home chores. So it is really a true fact that women are multitasking. So being a girl, being a mother, and being a grandmother, we have many roles, which is really a privilege, and we can enjoy all those experiences, which is only possible being a woman. So I'm really proud to be a woman and hope everybody or every one of you feels so. So women are as important as men in the society. A woman is a blessing for the society and women empowerment is one of the key terms for the overall development of that society. Because though we speak a lot about women, the empowerment is still, it has to take place. So we have to really work towards women empowerment to lift the women up. So the topic given to me today is psychosocial aspects of women health and empowerment of women on their health. So as already introduced by your vice principal, I'm Dr. Judy Arlappan. I'm the assistant professor and head of the Department of Maternal and Child Health, College of Nursing, Sultan Qaboos University, Muscat, Oman. So this is the place I'm working now. So this is our university campus. It's a very beautiful campus. This is the place where I'm working now. This is the College of Nursing, Sultan Qaboos University. So before starting, I would like to ask something about the fascinating story of Mercedes-Benz. So all of us love to have a car, that too a Mercedes-Benz, because it is a very costly car and it has it's very comfortable, and we enjoy going for a ride in this car. You know how many of you know about there is a strong woman behind the Mercedes-Benz? So the Carl Benz, who is the founder of Mercedes-Benz, he created this car in 1871. But during those periods, he had a fear of projecting his production to the society. So he was scared to tell people that he has created a car, and he was keeping in his garden itself, he was keeping in his backyard, and he was scared to test it outside. You know something? One day what happened, he went out somewhere. His wife is an old lady. She took the car and she went around and she drove the car directly to her mother's house. And then people noticed what a beautiful car it is, and people started ordering for the Benz model, and they started producing more. So it in long back itself, women have showed that they are really empowered. So she was so bold, and she has taken that step, and now Mercedes-Benz is one of the world's famous cars and everybody love having it. So what I'm trying to say is women have the capacity. Women are actually already empowered. Only thing in our society, due to various cultural reasons, we are held up. So, but we should be coming out of this. That is the reason I just told this story to you all. So there is a strong relationship between physical and mental health. So poor mental health is a risk factor for chronic physical conditions, because we cannot say that physical health is related to only the physiological mechanism. There is alteration in the physiological mechanism. It is not like that. So poor mental health has a direct relationship with the physical conditions, as well as people with serious mental health conditions are at higher risk of experiencing chronic physical conditions. So people with chronic physical conditions are at risk of developing poor mental health. So it is closely related to each other. So in order to have a good physical health, we should be mentally healthy as well. So people with the highest, people with highest level of stress end up with cancer. So stress is late. Stress causes cancer, more, occurrence of cancer in women. And depression has been found to be associated with an increased risk of coronary heart disease. And this depression is found to be higher among women. So it is causing more risk for getting coronary artery disease. And schizophrenia is associated with the risk of death from heart disease and three times the risk of respiratory disease. So people with depression are twice as likely to smoke as other people. See, when you are depressed, that tendency to smoke becomes more. And psoriasis is an autoimmune disease which is triggered by stress. And other than this, the heart disease, high blood pressure, weakened immune system, asthma, obesity, gastronomy problems, sleep disturbances, all these are related to stress and altered mental status. So what I'm trying to say is, if you are not mentally healthy, physically also we will not be healthy. So therefore, we are supposed to keep our mental mindset, mental makeup in a healthy state so that we will be physically healthy. So the prevalence of mental illness among women, in 2017, it was noted that the percentage of women being treated for mental illness was almost 50% higher than the percentage of men. So that means the women have the greatest percentage of mental illness. And the women diagnosed with depression. And women are more likely to get panic disorder. And the prevalence of serious mental illness is more common in women. Serious mental illness also affects the women more commonly. And exposure to violence is more common in women. You all know that. I don't have to say, because in India, we know about this exposure to violence. We have come across many cases where there are exposure to many cases of exposure to violence, and it is very common cause for depression. And by WHO, World Health Organization states that women who were exposed to sexual abuse as children or who have a violent partner as an adult are diagnosed with depression at a higher rate. And the research also says that severity and duration of the initial sexual or violent exposure impacts more on mental illness. And also, I would like to say that the research, literature says that many of the women in their lifetime, majority of the women are getting affected one or the other way with sexual abuse or violent exposure. So women are twice likely as men to be affected by unipolar depression. Women are more likely to suffer from a comorbid illness. That is, at a point of time, they may have two or three mental disorders in one person. And women are more likely to experience post-traumatic stress disorder, especially after the sexual abuse. It is very common. And women are almost 10 times more likely than men to be affected by eating disorder. So every psychosocial related illness are very common in women. That is the reason I thought I will just bring this statistics to your knowledge. So the various factors which leads to altered psychosocial problems are workload. So we are really, though we are multitasking, but we are loaded with lots of responsibilities. That's too much of responsibilities and too much of workload gives lots of pressure, and it leads to mental illness and physical illness. And stress among women is another cause. Migration, nutritional problems, gender-based discrimination, lack of economic independence, physical problems, sexual problems, lack of emotional safety and security, all these are the major factors which causes psychosocial problems among women. So especially the sexual problems are very sensitive issues which the women will not expose to outside world. They will keep it with themselves, and finally they will end up with many family problems, divorces, everything is related to the sexual problems. So these are the various factors which causes psychosocial disturbances in women. So the first one is violence in women, because 14-20% of women will experience rape at some point in their life. So it is a very high percentage, but we will not let it outside because of our cultural barriers. We will not let it outside. And 8-24% will be struck by someone known or unknown to them. So they are affected by either a known cause or an unknown person who either raped them or sexually assaults them. And 25-35% of women has been sexually abused as a child. So it is a very high percentage that they are affected or abused sexually as a child. So I would like to say an example here. When I was working in Chennai, we conducted a survey among 500 College of Nursing students to find out how many of them were sexually abused. We did not collect the name of the students. However, we kept the identifying information confidential. It is really surprising, out of 500 students, 72 students mentioned that they were sexually abused during their childhood by their known relatives. So it was really shocking for us. It is happening in our place. Then we really approached the students individually and we counseled them, and we really helped them a lot. As a group, we really helped the students and we're supporting them to come out of this crisis. So this is happening. It is only in a small survey which is done. If you do a survey across the country, we will have many cases. And childhood violence also has long-term psychological effects of on women. And especially when these children are affected with violence, it leads to depression and poor self-esteem. And the physical and sexual abuse in childhood leads to altered physical functioning and psychological well-being among women. So the next is depression in women. So women face depression, either as perinatal depression, depression before, after giving birth. So this, we call it as premenstrual dysmorphic disorder or depression related to perimenopause. So the women experience depression during different age, during their pregnancy, during after their delivery, and premenstrual depression, as well as depression related to menopausal period. So all these are various depressive episodes which are very common in women. So I would like to say an example of perinatal depression. One of my colleague, she was diagnosed to have perinatal depression. We were really not knowing what is the reason. One of the reasons is maybe hormonal influence. And later on, when she became normal, when I was talking to her, I came to know that her husband is working in Dubai and he had extramarital affairs. and she came to know about it. And finally, now she's become so depressed and she's not able to come out of that situation itself. And the depression continued till date, and she's very sick, and she's not able to come out as a normal individual. See, though there is a hormonal influence, other factors also influence women, the societal factors as well as the other extra factors which influences the women to get into depression. So this is another example I would like to highlight, because I am saying this example for you to be very vigilant, that we should, as females, we should be taking care of ourselves and we should be safe. That is the reason I'm giving these examples as students are participating in this webinar. And next, anxiety. Anxiety is also very common among women, and it is especially panic disorder, obsessive compulsive disorder, social anxiety disorder, separation anxiety disorder, phobia related disorder. All these are very common in women. And eating disorders are also very common in women, including anorexia nervosa and bulimia nervosa. It is again related to depression. When we are stressful, we tend to eat more, and which will lead to bulimia. And some women experience anorexia nervosa for excessive weight loss. So this is again related to stress. And body dysmorphic disorder, because people have extreme anxiety about their perceived physical defect, and they feel that they are very ugly, and they will go to a point where to seek remedy, and they go for plastic surgery to remove whatever is considered as per imperfection. And women having such problems have lots of difficulty to overcome this issue. And borderline personality disorder is also very common, where we have changeable moods, continually varying self-image, and inconsistent behavior. And this is again a big problem among women. And substance abuse. It is very surprising to note that adult women also are consuming illegal drugs. And it is very interesting to know that women can become addicted to drugs faster than men. Because I had a different belief that men will get addicted more. But the literature says that women can get addicted more than men. And because within a shorter span of time, they can get addicted to a illegal drug or any kind of abuses. So these sex hormones may be a cause for this effect on women. So women abuse drugs while pregnant will affect the baby, and smoking, everything during pregnancy, it again affects the baby, and the risk of stillbirth is very common among women. And the stigma and issues surrounding the women's mental health. So women may be less likely than men to seek treatment because of the stigma. We feel that when we are having some mental illness, how we can project it outside to the world. So people may think that I am a psycho, that they may isolate me. So with that belief, that many of the women, they never go for treatment, and they keep all the stress within themselves, and ultimately the intensity of the illness becomes high among women because of the stigma. And women's on mental health treatment, there are many resources available, though there are many challenges experienced by women. History, the psychosocial disturbances are very common among women. There are many resources available for women, like we can go to psychiatrists, psychologists, psychiatric mental health nurses like Dr. Blessy. Dr. Blessy used to counsel many people here. I have seen, even personally, I used to go to her, talk to her. She used to have a, you know, like very pleasant room, and the way she talks to us, and the way she helps us in solving the problem, it is really excellent. So when you know the sources, we can really get rid of these problems. And we have many social workers, support groups, online resources available. These are the various resources available to support the women who have mental health problems. So these are the various, some tips I would like to give on improving the mental health. So especially we have to develop the skills to cope with the ups and downs in everyday life. And aerobic exercise is very helpful because it will release the endorphins, which is very good for our body. We will keep ourselves calm, and regular physical exercise is very important. And we should have good sleep habits, and quality of sleep should be improved. And we should reduce the symptoms of anxiety and depression. And we should eat a balanced diet, healthy food. And we should avoid sugary food. We should avoid alcohol and coffee, because alcohol and coffee should be taken in moderation. And there are omega-3 fatty acids, folate, vitamin B12. Things are very much helpful for our physical and mental health. So we should also find a job we enjoy. We should not be working in a place where it is more stressful, and ultimately it will affect our physical and mental health. and invest in face-to-face relationship, which is very much missing in the current scenario, because we don't happen to meet people. Always we talk to them over phone, which is not a correct advice. We should really meet people face-to-face, and we should greet people directly, and we should engage in direct interaction with people to really enhance our mental health. And we should stay physically active, and we should avoid stressors in life. And the one important thing is there is a diet called Mediterranean diet, which includes daily consumption of vegetables, fruits, whole grains, healthy fats, and fish, poultry, beans, eggs, and moderate portions of dairy products, and limited intake of red meat. And the important aspect of Mediterranean diet is sharing meals with the family and friends, which is very limited nowadays because we are in the nuclear family system. We should really have good friends, and we should eat together, because if you see me, every weekend I will have guests in my house, because I make it a point that I have to be with my friends on weekends. Every day and Saturday, if you see my house, I will have friends. I will cook food. They bring food. We sit and enjoy together, talk to each other and enjoy together, so that it keeps us physically and mentally active and healthy. And sleeping well is very, very good. And finding a purpose in life, that is very important for us. We should all have a purpose in life and goal in life, so that this depression, anxiety, everything, we can get out of that problem. So we should really work towards women empowerment. The women should be empowered by giving education, raising the awareness, literacy, and training. And we should be involving them in the life determining decisions. And we should engage in psychological health promotion programs. And marital, sexual, reproductive choices should be made available for women. And public education and awareness campaigns should be made available for women. And very gender sensitive, comprehensive mental health programs should be made available for women to increase their mental health. And we should be giving timely support. And we should give psychologists appropriate diagnostic systems for women. And support must be provided by respecting their choices of treatment. So these are the various strategies with which we can enhance the psychosocial well-being of women. With this, I would like to conclude my presentation by saying that, again, I feel that I am very happy to be a woman. And I am very proud to say that I am a woman. I am born to a very strong woman. And in my status also, WhatsApp status, I say I'm a strong woman, because a strong woman raised me. That is my status even, because I feel that I'm a strong woman and a strong woman raised me. So with this short note, I would like to conclude my session. Thank you all for your patient listening. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for your valuable information. Gopi? Gopi? Gopi?
I'll complete the presentation.
So thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am. Gopi?
Can I start then? Is it next? Mine? Blessings.
Hello, Gopi, are you there? Gopi?
Okay.
Next.
Thank you.
Can next
I,
session.
Yes. I'm available. Am I audible to you, Mr. Gopi?
Yes, ma'am, you can proceed, ma'am.
Yes. Can I share the screen?
Yes, ma'am, you can share it.
Yes, ma'am.
My screen is seen to you. I mean, can you?
Ma'am, is it your desktop, ma'am? Which is displayed on the screen?
I can't, some technical issue. I can't.
Ma'am, Judy, ma'am, please remove your screen, ma'am, please.
I think still Dr. Judy's screen is
Judy, ma'am.
Screen sharing.
One minute. I closed it.
Okay.
No, ma'am, still it is open, ma'am. Your desktop. Now it is closed. Sakshi, you also remove it.
Blissy, you can go to share screen option, Blissy.
Yeah, I went. I think the camera of the laptop, which I am working on now, it is
okay.
It has a problem, I feel. I think I have to switch my computer. Yeah.
Next, ma'am, you can carry on, ma'am. Next, I request Dr. Ankita Patel, ma'am. Dr. Ankita, ma'am.
Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am. You can proceed, ma'am.
First of all, good afternoon, everyone. And I would like to thank Professor Churamani, ma'am, Dr. Judy, and Dr. Blissy for consenting to accept for accepting the invitation for this webinar on this day. And in fact, you all are in true sense example of women empowerment. And all our students and everybody attending this webinar will be definitely motivated and definitely enriched by your talk. So I will be basically speaking about the women's physical health.
How to share the screen.
Hello.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am. It's audible. You can proceed, ma'am.
Yeah, just.
Is my screen visible?
Yes, ma'am. Vartika.
Is the screen visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. It's visible. Not the screen. Oh.
So it's not visible.
You are visible. Screen is not visible.
So I think there is some issue. So I'll just share. I'll just talk like that only. So I'll be talking about women's physical. So according to WHO, health is a state of complete physical, mental, and spiritual well-being. Everybody is aware of. But in India, is it same for both the genders? Is it? No. So gender is one of the main social discriminant in health. I think Dr. Blessy has shared the screen. Should I continue?
Yes, ma'am.
I think Dr. Blessing.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am, by default.
So gender is one of the main social discriminant of health, which include all the aspects, social, economic, and political factor. And it definitely plays a major role in health outcome in women in India, and definitely access to healthcare. The studies have indicated that boys are more likely to receive treatment from healthcare facilities compared to girls. And the role of gender plays, healthcare access can be determined by examining the resource allocation within the household and the public sphere. Kind of patriarchy, which is existing in our society, definitely we have moved forward, and there has been various measures by government and various NGOs for women empowerment, and the things and the scenario has changed. But still, there are certain issues which is reflected in the health status of the female now also. So gender discrimination, it begins right from the birth. Female are the most commonly aborted sex in India, specifically in certain part of countries. But there are certain part of the country where there is a good sex ratio. But contrary to it, there are certain part of country where the sex ratio is definitely very much depressing. So if the female fetus is not aborted, the mother's pregnancy can be a stressful experience due to her family's preference for a son. So what are the various factors that determine the health concerns in a woman? So these are malnutrition, inadequate health services, gender discrimination, low level of education, especially in lower socioeconomic status, poor environmental hygiene, early childbearing, unsafe abortions, less employment opportunity, domestic violence, and definitely illiteracy. But in my opinion, what I feel is illiteracy is basically the root cause of every problem. So finally, if we talk about the solution, I think literacy is the first solution to every problem. So life cycle of a female has various issues at various ages, like in infancy and childhood from 0 to 9 years, it's sex selection, like female infanticide or feticide, genital mutilation, discriminatory nutrition and healthcare. In adolescent, that is 10 to 19 years of age, it is early childbearing, the getting married at very early age, and early childbearing, unsafe abortions, sexually transmitted infections, HIV, and malnutrition. In reproductive years, that is 15 to 49 years of age, unplanned pregnancy, and it is very, if we, I just went across a paper that though the government has taken many measures for the contraception, but still in outskirts and very remote areas, the people, the females, they have no access to contraception. So unplanned pregnancies, STIs and AIDS, unsafe abortion, again, pregnancy complications and malnutrition, especially iron deficiency in pregnant ladies and lactating females. And in post-reproductive age, like 45 plus, it's CVA, that is cardiovascular diseases, gynecological cancers, basically CA cervix, CA endometrium, CA breast, CA ovary, osteoporosis, osteoarthritis, and diabetes. These are the major morbidities which our females are facing as of now. And surprisingly, and these all are preventable. Say cardiovascular, if we have certain screening protocol for blood pressure, cholesterol, and if it is mandated, if it is made mandatory for all the females, the incidence of cardiovascular disease will definitely come down. Gynecological cancer, say CA cervix, it is completely preventable if we are getting vaccination and a pap smear after age of 21. CA cervix, vaccination and pap smear. CA breast, completely preventable. If not preventable, if it is detected at a very early stage by clinical examination, self breast examination, and by mammography, it is kind of curable. And now the patient are surviving for 10 years or more in breast carcinoma because the disease has been understood very nicely. There are very nice treatment. There are very good molecules, very good chemotherapy, and every treatment thing is very much developed. And the patient are having 10 to 15 or more than that life expectancy in CA breast. Osteoporosis, definitely vitamin D deficiency. If you survey in any age, irrespective of age group, about 70 to 80% of the female will have vitamin D deficiency. The reason being, now we are getting less exposure to sun, and that is the main reason. And then definitely that will be the how to eradicate it. Osteoarthritis and diabetes. So these are the lifestyle diseases, and definitely curable and preventable. Nutritional problem that exists in India is, on one hand, obesity, and on the other hand, it's undernutrition, anemia, premenstrual symptom, and now eating disorders like anorexia nervosa, bulimia nervosa, and binge eating. Nutritional deficiencies, like nutritional deprivation, has been major consequence of different ailments. Only small proportion of women in India are consuming balanced diet. Deficient intake of nutrients such as calcium, iron, magnesium, zinc, folic acid, vitamin A, vitamin B6, vitamin C are found more proportion to young women than young men in a study in India. And malnutrition is major consequence of anemia. 50 to 90% of all pregnant women in India suffer from anemia. Severe anemia accounts for 20% of all the maternal death. This was an old study, but the situation has not much improved. The prevalence of osteoporosis, osteoarthritis, backache are the common health problem among the elderly women in India, and its prevalence is more in women as compared to men. And osteoporosis and osteoarthritis are silently progressing metabolic bone disease in a widely prevalent in India and is a common cause of morbidity and mortality in women. Low calcium diet and lack of health awareness are two major causes behind the health problems. So, what are the measures towards the healthy life? First, to know how to be healthy, to know what is a balanced diet, to know what are the symptoms, when to see doctor, and to develop the concept of screening. The concept of screening, not only for cancer, but for a normal parameter is very important. What is the current practice? If the patient is having headache or the patient is having any kind of symptom, then only the patient is visiting, and eventually the patient comes out to be case of hypertension or uncontrolled diabetes or cancer in advanced stage, because we are approaching healthcare facility only on symptom. So first of all, we have to imbibe this in ourselves and also in our, because we are healthcare workers, so we have to educate our people to develop the concept of screening to detect the any problem at very initial stage or before developing, if rather than prolonging it and getting into a stage. So balanced diet is important, proper exercise is important, and adequate sleep on regular basis to decrease or manage stress. Family planning and reproductive life plan is very important. Immunization is very important. Screening protocols and screening examinations are very important. And approach to health holistically, spiritually, physically, and socially. So, because right now I am addressing the adolescent girl basically. So, adolescent girl, they need to access information and services related to nutrition, reproductive health, family planning, and general health. Programs can measures and the screening protocols. And all the girls, they should receive enough food, iron, folate. This is not the age to diet and control your diet. Everyone should get daily basis enough calories and should adequate amount of each micro and macronutrient are getting it. Because if we are healthy, we are healthcare workers. If we are healthy, then we'll be a role model for others. So definitely we need to use our knowledge of nutrition in all the spheres, starting from our house when preparing and handling the food. That is also very important. And outside, I would like to say that this corona has definitely, it is a panic. This is our now new normal, but it has taught us many new aspects, very healthy life. And after this crisis is gone, we should continue to follow whatever this corona has taught us. The social distancing, the hygiene practices which we are following in our house, outside. So this we should follow. And definitely everything comes with a lesson, and we should adopt it and continue to follow all the precautions in our life. So, and twice yearly, like every 6 monthly, deworming is very important. This is also a very important cause of anemia in our country. And now coming to health screening, every age has different requirement, but there are certain screening thing which is which should be taken care in all the age groups, like blood pressure check, blood test, clinical breast examination, urine analysis, and proper height and weight up to 15 years of age. This is very important. And for the girls or the teenagers up to in their 20s, the screening protocol for menstrual issues, STDs, and education about contraception, education about pregnancy is very important. And definitely lifestyle is very important in this age group. Monthly self-breast examination should be done by all the females, and annually physical examination should be done by a clinician, which includes clinical breast examination, blood pressure, and blood test. STD screening, if you are sexually active, is mandatory. Vision screening is important. After 21 years of age, every 3 yearly, if you are married, pap smear is mandatory. And this goes up to 50 or 65 years of age. Every 5 years, blood sugar and cholesterol screening is important. But if there is high risk obese, or if there is a family history, the frequency can be earlier also. And in 30s, the screening which is needed is monthly self-breast examination, annually clinical breast examination by doctor, blood pressure check, blood test, and every 2 to 5 years of gap, blood sugar test is required, cholesterol test is required, and pelvic examination and pap smear. Again, starting from 21 years of age, every 3 yearly to 65 years of age. And we are also doing HPV test. So if HPV test is done, then this pap smear frequency is 5 yearly. Like pap smear plus HPV, if done together, then the frequency of the test is 5 yearly. And if only pap smear is done, the frequency is 3 yearly. So this is for cervix. And if you're talking for breast, it is annual clinical examination. In early 30s, we normally don't recommend mammography for breast cancer. normally mammography is advised after 40 years of age, but if the patient or if any individual is having any high risk factor, or she is having family history of breast cancer, or she is having any genetic trait, then the test can be started 10 years at the age of 30 years, or 10 years before the age of the index case. Like the first case in the family was detected at 35, so the screening in the person should start at 25 years of age. And at the age of 40, in 40s, again, monthly breast examination is required. Annual breast examination, blood pressure, blood test, and cholesterol testing is required. Mammography starts at age of 40. Eye test is required. Every 5-yearly blood sugar monitoring, but if there is high risk or if there is a family history, then annual blood sugar can be monitored. Colonoscopy, because the incidence of malignancy is increasing in India because change in the dietary habit. So colonoscopy is advised for high-risk women. High-risk means having a history of CA colon in family. So colonoscopy is advised in high-risk patient from age of 40. Gender advised about 50 years, but in high-risk cases, it is advised at the age of 40 and then after 10 years. And definitely pap smear again goes, we have to do continuously till 65 years of age. And we at this point of time, it is very right time to discuss with your clinician about the menopause symptoms and ovarian screening. Because menopause is one of the important kind of in females, it the ovaries goes and it comes and it brings various symptoms like hot flushes, irritation, etc. And that is really distressing for the female. So definitely age 40 or beyond is very right time to discuss with the clinician about the menopausal symptoms. Now, beyond 50, it's a high-risk group. There is a risk of stroke, colon cancer, ovarian cancer, heart disease, and osteoporosis. Old age itself is a big risk factor for having malignancy. So definitely this is the group where we have to take care about the cardiovascular status, about the malignancy. And definitely it's any disease comes with multi-organ involvement. So definitely complete clinical examination as frequently as possible with the development of symptom is very important. For colon cancer, we should do colonoscopy at the age of 50 and followed by after 10 years. And if there is any family history or any high risk or a history of polyp, any high risk factor, then it should be done starting at the age of 40. Ovarian cancer, very common cancer, and it is detrimental because our abdomen is a space. Ovary, it comes treated as early as possible and to get the complete treatment. Then only the disease can be cured. So see ovary, and then the symptom will be discharged from
Aadhar card de dijiye, PAN card de dijiye, mummy ka passbook de dijiye.
Any female who develops bleeding post menopause needs a medical
attention.
Osteoporosis can be kind of prevented by taking vitamin D supplementation, which is mandatory, which should be, and definitely sun exposure for 20-30 minutes is mandatory for all the females. And 20% of women in their 50s already have osteoporosis. And if possible, get a DEXA scan done. DEXA scan is very simple investigation, and it will tell the density of and the intensity of the bone loss. So coming to vaccination is must. Our government has already the vaccination plan that is mandatory for females. Especially there is the HPV, which is again CS cervix, and it there are two type of vaccines, quadrivalent and bivalent, and they can be given from 9 years to 20 age. Some papers say up to 45 years of it, but it's better to get early in life. and it is given in 3 doses. And as of now, it is stated that it will decrease the incidence of CA cervix. And surprisingly, because CA cervix basically happens in lower socioeconomic, and it has to do with HPV virus. And this HPV virus is 99% of cases of because of HPV virus. So this vaccine is against that HPV virus. So it is deemed effective. And so these are various aspects of health of female, which includes the nutrition and screening and various supplements. And one of the most important, less discussed thing is violence. And it has been seen that the violence in India is, or maybe across the world, 70 to 80% is in the family because of the family members. And it can be domestic abuse, sexual, and in very severe cases, it can be murder as well. So, according to National Crime Record Bureau, reported incidents of crime against women increased 6.4% during 2012. And a crime against a woman is committed every 3 minutes. And then after 2 years, the incidence, it raised to 44%. So, and it's not happening only in lower socioeconomic status or illiterate or less educated population. Every socioeconomic category or every sphere of females from all the spheres, all the walk of life, they are suffering from some kind of violence, be it at the working place, at social place, or in their own house. And for some females, their house is the most unsafe place to live in. So definitely various government agencies and NGOs, they are doing lots of work and lots of effort to raise awareness, because most of the female, they will not speak up. They will try to bind the things. They will try to continue the work they are doing. And that is why they will not speak up. And this gives encouragement to the opposite, the culprit. So there are various agencies, they are taking care, they are encouraging the females, and definitely we have to be self-dependent, and we should seek help immediately. If we tolerate for the first time, definitely that is the biggest encouragement, and that is going to continue. So speak up, because violence is never okay, never okay, and educate yourself about the cause, about the consequences of the violence, and definitely learn more about the domestic and family violence and spread awareness. So it's just not about the women, it's just for entire fraternity. Addressing women's health is necessary and effective approach to strengthen the health system overall, and action, it will benefit everyone. Improving women's health matters to women, to their families, communities, and societies at large. And improving the world's women's health will definitely improve the world. And definitely a good soul lives in a healthy body, and if we are healthy, our family will be healthy, and the entire country and world will be healthy. And if we are healthy, then only we can raise a better next generation. Whatever this generation is facing, the next generation should not face, and that will come only by literacy, education, spreading awareness, and standing for yourself. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for your valuable explanation regarding physical aspects of women. Gopi?
Hello? Is it audible, ma'am? Hello?
Hello, Gopi?
Next, I would like to request Dr. Blessing, ma'am. Yes, ma'am? Blessy ma'am. Hello. Hello.
Hello. I was, yeah. Hello. Mr.
Yes, ma'am, you can proceed. Yes, ma'am. You can proceed the session, ma'am.
Yeah, I was.
Stress reduction strategies.
I'm trying to share the screen now.
Yes, ma'am, it is visible, ma'am.
Oh, okay. Now it is visible, right? Yeah. I cannot put the full screen mode. That's okay, maybe. Okay, that's okay. I can't see the full screen. So as long as you can see, it's fine. Let us start with the stress reduction strategies for safe womanhood. I appreciate, hats off to my previous speakers, Dr. Judy Arulappan and Ms. Ankita. You both have beautifully elaborated both the psychosocial aspects and physical aspects of the womanhood and their issues, what they suffer. So now I would like to share some of the stress reduction strategies to combat all these issues. So celebrate womanhood. Already my eminent speakers here have explained, and Dr. Judy very beautifully shared that how she feels that she is a strong woman. The moment this woman believes that she is strong, she will spread that strength to the surrounding and the positivity to the surrounding, and so that she can empower others. So we have the power to create our own destiny. If it is to be, it is up to me. This is the belief everybody should have. So I design my own life, write my own story. So be very creative to write the most beautiful, most happy story for yourself and for others. Now, in my 15 minutes of my discussion, we will just see what the successful people will do, and some tips I will share, and some strategies I will discuss. And of course, mindfulness is the most powerful tool nowadays everybody assimilate or take along with to lead a successful life, that we will discuss, and relaxation practice together we will do. So escape some of the strategies, and maybe the most successful people, how they lead the life is from escaping the grip of the past. Don't let the past cloud your future and ruin your present. So this is very, very important. Everybody, see, you shared, all both of the speakers and even the guests, chief guests had been sharing that many of the and the shocking or revelational disclosure Dr. Judy shared with us, that out of 500 nursing students, that you see, they have come to a professional stream. In spite of that, there are so many other similar children in our society. So just imagine. So this, among this 572, means it's a large 1/5 of the population, isn't it? So they are, had been suffering some of the molestation and incest in the childhood. So this one will carry a negative baggage, a very heavy baggage along with them. And they will not be able to focus on to their present or to the future, because this worry will be there in the subconscious. It will be submerged in the subconscious, and this will color and this will ruin their present and the future. So they have to come out of, like Phoenix bird, they have to resurrect and come out of all this agonies and past failure, negativity and all that. So then only they can focus on to the present moment. So it is possible by everybody, all the women. So from today onwards, just escape from the grip of the past, leave the luggage in the dustbin, just throw it away and be lighter yourself. And so that you will, your journey will be light and smooth and happy one. Escape from the mind traps. So I have just put this, try to put the E into this so that you will remember at the end of the day some take home messages or to carry with you. It would be easy, I thought. So I have put again another E tip, escape from the mind traps. This is from my study, my PhD and my years of work and time spent on learning cognitive behavioral therapy. Everything is, there's a negative, in every person there is an alternative self or a subconscious. Sometimes we too, there will be, if you analyze, sit quietly and analyze yourself, there will be a negative talk going on, or any talk will be going on all the time. As you are listening to me also, maybe you are thinking something else in the mind. So there is always a talk going on. So this is called, or there is some deep-rooted beliefs in each person. This is called schema. Some schema will be some very negative, and this will pull down the person very badly. So this schema, we have to analyze ourselves. Actually, very expert psychotherapist is needed, or a psychologist is needed. But I understand in India or anywhere else in the world, it is very difficult to approach or to access a psychologist. So, but it is possible, each one of us has our own therapist within ourselves. So utilize, encourage, empower that therapist in you. So identify your schema. That means the deep-rooted belief system. So sometimes it will be of hopelessness, helplessness, worthlessness, all that. See, my previous speakers have shared about body image disturbances and all that. I'm not worthy. I'm not beautiful. Nobody loves me. This and all the common negative beliefs many of the women, those who have. This will be ruining your day, ruining your years of life, and ruining not only your life, and the people around you also will be negatively toned by your belief. So this is very dangerous for yourself and for others. So identify such beliefs, such as maladaptive beliefs, such as, or it is even called as dysfunctional belief. So I will fail, for example. So instead, change it, correct it to a positive one. I will succeed. Unlovability, like no one loves me. Think that I am a lovable person. See, love, happiness, everything is, there is a big factory within us. There is a big chemical factory. So we can generate everything within ourselves. Once we generate, we will not never be in dearth or shortage of any of these positive emotions. So this is very, very essential for each one of us to generate, create all these positive emotions. So the moment we start creating it, it will overflow. And the beauty is that we will attract positive people to ourselves, to our lives. So everything will be brightened. Embrace the things you cannot change. So this is, the simple term is acceptance. Many things like, see, past you cannot go back and change, but so you can forget, forgive, all these things you can try out. And you can, otherwise, some past means, some negative experiences always utilize for learning. Okay, always failure is a stepping stone for success, isn't it? So Grammy, always pray, have a positive, powerful affirmation like, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, the courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the differences. So always have this serenity of mind to accept and embrace whatever you cannot change. Many things, so even the challenges ahead of you will be a beautiful thing that will be helping you to positively chart your journey. So take it positively with an optimistic mind. Everything will go smoothly. Now, equalize the work and life, very important. My previous speakers, my colleagues and my friend, she was beautifully explaining, Dr. Judy was telling that multitasking, this is the beauty of woman. For example, I am a mother, I am a careerist, I am an individual to the society, I am a wife. So many multiple feathers are there with me. And I try to manage everything in a balance. We may not be. See, perfectionism, again, another trap. You may not be perfect 100% in all the arenas of life. But you, as long as you believe in yourself that you are discharging your duties to the best possible, according to your best abilities, then nothing to worry. Go ahead. And see, what always try to do what you like to do. You, if you enjoy what you do, then nothing can stop you. See, you are a mother and you are a careerist. So you cannot always say that I have to put my 100% into the work, then the personal life will suffer. If you the personal life is suffering, you will never be a happy person. If you are unhappy with yourself, you will discharge that unhappiness. You will spread it to the students or the career to your patients, isn't it? So this is a balance. Cut the balance always between your personal life and professional life. Both are very essential. So take it in both the hands and always try to balance. You just check yourself whether are you as it balanced. Anything is going up and down, just consciously balance it because both are required for a successful life. So what we can do? Enrich your career skills. So if you are falling short of some skills in the career, that will again pull you down. Others will comment, or isn't it that you will be preoccupied with that? That will intonate or reflect on the other side. So always do. If you are an educator, maybe attending conferences. Even now, today you are attending a webinar. Why? Because you want to empower yourself so that you can empower others, isn't it? So this is all positive activity. Engage in that. Publish or read or maybe learn computer skills. Anything you can learn, whatever, even in your personal life. For example, last week I was learning, I guess two weeks back, I guess hypnosis or the hypnotherapy. To some extent, I will incorporate that in my today's session. So like that, we can empower. And in personal life, at the age of 40, the starting of 40, I have learned Bharatanatyam, you know. It was easy for me because I was always a dancer from childhood. I had learned. So cycling, I learned in my late 30s with my children. As they started cycling, I learned with them. So anything is possible for a woman or for anybody for that matter. Because men are also listening to our talk. So we are not in distress or disharmony with anybody because coexistence is the motto. They are the best supporters for women. So we also need to support them in turn. Engage your senses creatively. See, the senses collect, the five senses are very important. How we perceive things, everything is problem. Actually, there is nothing called for problem. It's all our perception. We perceive things, if we just change our vision, if we see the problem as an opportunity, it is never a problem for us, isn't it? So engage your senses creatively and effectively. All the senses of taste, sight, smell, hearing and touch, make it a positive experience every day, every time. Like engage in like cooking with nice aromatic dishes, or maybe use nice aroma, listen to music, paint, travel, listen to music or dance, whatever you like in your personal life. So engage. Dr. Judy rightly mentioned she engaged with the good people. She always cook good food and share. So these are a way of coping in life. This combat the stress. Engage with positive people, very, very essential for us. because we also need motivation, isn't it? We keep motivating others, and in turn, we need also motivation to go ahead in life. So always have the intuition to identify the different types of people, those who come across. Some people are negative people. They will suck your energy. Energy mongers, it's called. So you need to stay away from them. Sometimes it is not possible if you if you happen to be with them most of the time. Then I wish you the best of luck and all the positivity so that you come out, give them more love. Maybe increase the dose of love towards them so that they change. It may be a Herculean task, but take it as a challenge and opportunity to change somebody positively. Otherwise, if they are not very closely related, if you can just avoid them, ignore them, then do that, because you will save your energy for the better things. You have better things to do. So you can identify from the aura or with your intuitive power. If you refine that every time, you will be able to identify people by the way of talk, way of look, way of exchanges and behavior. You can identify pure positive people. So try to be with them. Find good mentors in life so that it will be good for you to come up. Positive people, they don't wait for positivity. They just create it and spread it. Negative people, rather, they spread negativity, resentment. They complain and spread bad news always. Try to do that. So just stay away from them. Then emotions, reinvent them positively. Emotions are powerful tools in life. So I told about negative thinking, dysfunctional thinking. Same way, emotions are also one part. Another part is behavior, your own behavior. So to channelize your behavior correctly, positively, you need to track your thinking as well as your emotions. Very, very essential. So this is a triangle. Thinking, emotions, and behavior go hand in hand. So always track your emotions and revitalize, reinvent. Okay, joy, gratitude, serenity, interest, hope, pride, amusement, inspiration, wonder. All these are positive emotions. So these emotions are listed by Barbara Fredrickson, University of North Carolina. So these are very powerful emotions. So use this create this positive emotions in you. It is possible. And energize your body and mind. I'm not explaining each one because my friends have already gave you some tips on this. Focus only on positive experiences, positive affirmations. I am, it's possible for me. I am beautiful. I am optimistic. I can do it. Such powerful affirmations. It is up to me. I can do it. Such powerful affirmations you try to tell yourself very frequently. And even you can write down and put in your mirror all that. So when you have a challenging day in front, it is possible. Like that. You just read it loud for yourself. It is possible. So whatever you visualize, it will be manifested for you. Gratitude, again, it's a powerful tool. You have gratitude to everybody around. So my prayer most of the time, morning and evening, it is mostly gratitude. Gratitude for the abundance. Gratitude for the beautiful people surrounding me. Everything. So this works well. This works miraculously in your life. Conscious act of kindness. Always you see there is endorphins will be produced more and more. Through researches, it has found that when you engage in kind activities, you will be more positive and more kindness will be shown to you, towards you by others as well. So it's very true. I experienced that every time in my life. Eat right. Just now also, because of the technical issue, I am supposed to attend another meeting. This is now it is 11:24 here in the in Oman. My dean has just posed, no, he has permitted me to be here. And then after this, I can join the other executive meeting of 2 days. So always people will be kind towards you when you are kind to others. Eat right, exercise, sleep well, and also meditate. Meditation is, again, it's an Eastern tradition now followed every worldwide. It regulates your thoughts, emotions, keep aligned your energy, focus your everything. It increases your concentration and power. So practice that every day. Encourage and empower. Be a woman who supports other women. Compliment each other. Give words of encouragement and empower each other. So this is very, very essential. You need to be sharing and caring so that the world will sustain beautifully. Now, so these are the tips I have mentioned. Now we will go to the strategies of one, because in short time we cannot discuss so many things. But there are NLP and so many neurolinguistic programming and hypnotherapy, I guess, hypnosis, so many powerful tools are there for stress management. We need not know everything. At least one, if we know thoroughly, that will help us to go forward positively. So we analyze, is our mind full or mindful? Try to make our mind mindful always. What is mindfulness? A moment by moment awareness of thoughts, feelings, bodily sensations, and surrounding environment through a gentle, nurturing mind so that you will be calm all the time. So you can, with this technique, you can even find help the stressful women around you. So I'm teaching you fishing today so that you can teach others fishing. So let's beat the stress with this mindfulness. I hope, do I have 5 minutes for this practice, Mr. Gopi?
Yes, ma'am. Please do it, ma'am. Ma'am, this is Jansi. Okay, please continue, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you, Ms. Jansi. I will just lead you to a relaxation. It will take some 5 minutes. So wherever you are seated, just give all your weight onto the chair or couch, whichever in totally leave your total body weight onto the chair which you are being seated right now, and just focus on your breath. Okay, and your palm, let it be resting on your knees or your lap. Just in a very totally relaxed mood, please be seated. Okay, now you are just being aware. You are gradually being aware of your surroundings and your breathing. Now focus on to your breathing. Take deep breaths. As I say, breathe in, take deep breath, and gradually breathe out. Continue this deep breathing. Breathe in. Breathe out. So gradually you are taking deep breath. Focus on to the breath. It is very soothing. The air is very cool and it is slowly passing through your nostrils and entering to your lungs. It is a very cool feeling. You're totally calm. A lot of positive energy is taking into your body along with the breath. You're totally getting a peaceful experience. Now, gradually you focus your attention to your eyelids. It is gradually becoming heavier and heavier. And now you can gradually look on to your arms, which is rested in your laps. Gradually look down. And at the same time, you are being aware of your body and your breathing. The breathing is very soothing. And as you breathe in, you are taking in positive energy, lot of love and lot of compassion. You are being energized along with each breath. Now gradually close your eyes. As you close your eyes, you feel really empowered and happy. Now you can just visualize the surrounding in your inner mind. You are standing in a beautiful house, and the surrounding, you can, it is all pleasant and it's absolutely quiet area. And as you move down, you can go forward, you can see that there is some steps. You can see some steps, and gradually you decide to go down the step. Go down the first step, you feel that you are more empowered and energized. The second step, again, you are revitalized. A lot of energy is filling in to your all the cells of the body. Again, you are taking the third step. Again, a lot of positive feeling. Fifth step, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth. And you reach the last step, tenth step. And this is a plain area, well lit. And towards the left, as you can see a very nice decorated door on the left. And you are intrigued. What could be within that? And you see a golden knob for that door. You gradually open it and you are entering to a big room. It just looks like a control room of your mind. And you realize that you had never been here, but always you were interested to come in here. Today that you got opportunity to be here, and you see the both side, you see that in the left side there are so many buttons, and even the right side there are so many buttons. So you are attracted to the left side. You see it's red buttons, or it's a control panel with red buttons, and you can see the buttons. It's written marked with one thing. It is the first one. It is stress. Oh, you want to avoid this, isn't it? So it is possible by you. It is marked 1 to 10. And you see it is in the level of 8. You can bring down as much as possible by turning the button or manipulating the button. You are doing that now. You can do it now. Just bring down the stress button to 0. It is possible. Oh, you did that. You are happy about it. You feel a lot of burden is removed from your heart. And you feel free now. Now you are seeing another button. It is anger, written anger. It's again red and hot. It is almost in 7. Bring it down. It is possible. Bring it down to 0 or 2, whichever level you want, you, it is possible. And you are doing it now, right now. And it is resentment on the third button. You are bringing it down to the lowest 0. And there is frustration, procrastination, all negativity, all that one by one. You are controlling all that. You are bringing it down to the 0 or to the lowest 1. So you feel very happy about all this. And you are, now that you feel free and very light, very energized, and you are gradually to the end of the left, and now some unwanted habit you, it's there in you, which that also you want to bring it down. It is you are totally free for that because you are in the control. Okay, now you, I'm giving you time, letting you to bring it even that down. Now you did that. The right, and it is all green buttons. You see, there is love. Yeah, you're happy about it. You're raising it. And you see that, for your surprise, you see that it is 0 to 100. And it is somewhere around 20. So you are raising it. You are raising it to the 100. And you are feeling very happy about it. Now that you have, you see happiness. Again, you are raising it to the 100. You are very happy about it. You can see that everything is magnified. Everything is beautiful. Everything is light up, lightened up. Everything is positive. So many positive and gratitude. Everything you are raising into the upper level, energy, optimism, everything you have raised it. Now you are totally free from the bright room. As you entered, the room was very dark or dull. Now you are with a lot of brightness within you. You are gradually coming out and you are slowly closing the door behind you. And you can see the steps, the same step. You're climbing one by one. As you step one, the feelings within you, the positivity is doubling up and you are very happy about it. You are climbing one step, second, third, fourth, seventh, eighth, ninth, and 10. You are now in your same level where you started and you feel totally stress-free, positive, energized, revitalized, as reborn you feel. Now you can focus totally on exactly what you want in life. And you all visualize yourself and in your life. Now you are sure that you can focus totally on exactly on the priorities in your life. And you can manage your time. You can organize your life beautifully well. Now you are totally a people. Now you have, you can slowly open your eyes and you can feel the calmness in the surrounding. I hope you are all okay. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now we can, I will go to the conclusion. So this was a control room, a slight hypnotherapy come a mindfulness practice I made you to do. This is anytime you can do it. Anytime you can practice this, whenever you are stressful, you are free to go to your control room and control your emotions fully. And I wish you best. Go spread the light, let the world be bright because of you. It is possible. Nothing can be light that shines from within. We all are so powerful beacons of light, and you can brighten the surrounding. You can spread the positivity, and I wish you the best. Every woman is full beyond.
Thank you so much. Beyond
description. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. It was very kind. Mindful intervention, which I shared with you. Next, I request Professor R. Gandhi for the principal effects of the nothing Varanasi to share few words on this occasion.
Hello, Gopi. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am.
Okay, good afternoon to one and all. Today's session is going good. A woman is an art, the patience to listen, the willingness to understand, the power to care. It is a right of each woman. In order to insist the importance and to spread the knowledge of health of women, our role model, source of energy, and the real inspiration of each member of Apex Hospital and Apex Higher Professional Educational Institutions Varanasi and Chunar, Honorable Chairman Dr. S.K. Singh Sir and Directors Dr. Saru Patel and Dr. Angita Patel motivated us to conduct this wonderful webinar on International Day of Action for Women's Health. So we are ever thankful to our management for their light of guidance to make us to travel in right path. We are very honored and lucky to have today's chief guest, Padmasri and Dr. B.C. Roy, National Awardee, Dr. Churamani Gopal, former VC of King George Medical University, Lucknow, and guest of honor, respected Dr. Judy Arilappan, HOD of Maternal and Child Health Department, Qaboos University, Oman, and special guest, Dr. Blessy Prabha, Valsaraj, HOD of Community and Mental Health Department, Qaboos University, Muscat, Oman, respected our director, ma'am, on this wonderful occasion. As WHO states, health is a state of complete physical, mental, and social well-being and not merely absence of diseases or infirmity. Today, our respected eminent resource speakers explain beautifully in detail about various aspects of health issues of women and the strategies to overcome from psychological issues. Thank you, ma'am, for your valuable information. There is no doubt that today's session is most useful for us. So thank you all for your coordination and support to the successful organization of this event. I would like to extend my warm wishes and special thanks to our organizing team of today's program and Mr. Sanjeev Sharma, Public Relations Officer, Mr. Gopi, Principal in Charge, Apex College of Nursing, Chunar, for their timely help and coordination in all the program of Apex College of Nursing. If one woman is educated in a family, means the whole family is educated. Same way, when you give good health to one woman, she will safeguard her entire family. So, care women, protect her health, spread awareness regarding health of women. With this, I shall conclude my address. Our lovable students are waiting to ventilate their talents. Let us watch and enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Next, I would like to request Anushi to participate in this session, to proceed the session. Some of the students' activities is performed by students. Some video presentations, poetry, and posters are preferred by the students on this occasion. So this will be shared very soon. To stay on this.
Hello?
Anushi, you can proceed.
Okay.
Thank you, Gopi sir. Good afternoon all. This is me, Anushi, faculty of Apex College of Nursing. And I am very happy to celebrate International Women's Health with you all. And in our first session, we heard very crucial information from our esteemed colleagues. And I'm going to introduce this second session. This session is a student oriented session. And poster. So, the first presentation belongs to GM.
Anushi, proceed to the next session.
Okay. Our next program is foreign participation, and for that, I'm starting with BSc 4-year
students. Anushi, please. Vaishali is where you present it up. 4th year BSc.
What, sir?
4th year BSc
okay,
video.
Okay. We are leaving poem recitation. We are starting with 4th year BSc video.
Can I proceed?
Yes, sir, you can proceed.
Proceed the next.
Okay, we are proceeding towards poem recitation, and I'm calling one by one. So I'm starting with BSc 4-year student Miss Ekta. Miss Ekta. Hello, Ekta. Ekta, are you there? Ekta?
Yes, ma'am.
Ekta, you can start.
Okay, ma'am. Good afternoon, everyone. Myself, Ekta Maurya, student of BSc Nursing 4th year. On the day of World Women Health Day, I'm going to present my poetry. Aao, aaj main kisse tumhe sunati hoon, jin baaton se tum darte ho, un baaton ko samjhati hoon. मैं औरत हूँ, मैं बेटी हूँ, मैं औरत हूँ, मैं बेटी हूँ, ये मेरे मन की बात है, क्या हिम्मत से सुन पाओगे जो मेरे हालात हैं? ना इक्वालिटी ना बलात्कार आज मैं तुमसे बोलूंगी, ना इक्वालिटी ना बलात्कार आज मैं तुमसे बोलूंगी, सुनो चुप रहना मत कहना कुछ अंदर की बातें खोलूंगी। मासिक, पीरियड, मेंसुरेशन और भी नाम है, कोई बात नहीं करता, बस ये चीज बहुत ही आम है। ना भाई को ना पापा को, ना भाई को ना पापा को किसी को बताना मत, जब वो ऐसा कुछ बेटी तुम घबराना मत। हाँ हमको इस समय बस यही बताया जाता है, इसके नाम पे बेटी को बस यही सिखाया जाता है। ना बेड मिले तो ऐसे में वो नीचे भी सो जाती है, ना बेड मिले तो ऐसे में वो नीचे भी सो जाती है। एक बात बताओ, ये लड़की सच में अपवित्र हो जाती है? बैठ जाओ ना खेल कूद ना ही अब तुम दौड़ करो, बैठ जाओ ना खेल कूद ना ही अब तुम दौड़ करो, और इन दिनों में बेटा तुम इग्नोर थोड़ा और करो। एक सवाल है बचपन से, एक सवाल है बचपन से, क्या कोई मुझे समझाएगा? नहीं जाऊंगी मंदिर पर, वहां से देवी माँ को कौन हटाएगा? मैं साफ हूँ, मैं साफ हूँ, कैसे समझाऊं, मुझको मंदिर जाने दो, ना आओ घर ना मुझको और बहाने दो। नहीं बोलते नहीं बातें करते जिसकी, जिसको तुम टैबू मानते हो, उसके बिना ना होते तुम क्या ये मानते हो? क्यों चुप होंगे क्यों बैठेंगे क्यों इसको हम छुपाएंगे, क्यों चुप होंगे क्यों बैठेंगे क्यों इसको हम छुपाएंगे, लड़का हो या लड़की हम ये बात सबको बताएंगे। सैनिटरी नैपकिन क्यों छुपा कर ले जाए हम, ये साधारण सी बात है, क्यों ना इसको आम बनाए हम। जो चलता आ रहा उस चीज को अब रुक जाने दो, ये तो गर्व की बात है, अब लड़की का सर में सर से झुकने दो। कुछ समझना हो तो ना सवाल करो, ना इस बात पे तुम बवाल करो, ज्यादा मत इंस्पेक्ट करो, है सच्चाई एक्सेप्ट करो। मैं इसमें भी प्योर हूँ, टेंशन ना लो श्योर हूँ, अरे छुपाऊं ऐसी बात नहीं, लड़की होना अपराध नहीं। फील करो और बात करो, लिशन हमारे साथ करो, जो दिखे दाग घबराना मत, बताने में शर्माना मत। भैया पैकिंग अच्छी वाली दो, बस पन्नी अब मत काली दो, जो बात करे बेशर्म नहीं, ये कोई गंदा कर्म नहीं। अब यही गाएंगे राग हम, स्पोर्ट्स में लेंगे भाग हम, सेफ्टी अब हम चूज करे, ना होना कंफ्यूज करे, ये मेरे मन की बात थी, ये मेरे मन की बात है, मत मानो मत पसंद करो, बस एक ही रिक्वेस्ट है, इसे टैबू कहना बंद करो, इसे टैबू कहना। थैंक यू मैम।
ओके थैंक यू एकता। नेक्स्ट आई एम कॉलिंग पल्लवी, बीएससी थर्ड ईयर। पल्लवी बीएससी थर्ड ईयर। पल्लवी
हेलो
हेलो हेलो यस पल्लवी यू कैन स्टार्ट।
हेलो यस गुड आफ्टरनून टू वन एंड ऑल, दिस इज पल्लवी यादव फ्रॉम बीएससी नर्सिंग थर्ड ईयर। कन्या से स्त्री बन सदियों से समाज की जिम्मेदारी उठाते आ रहे हूँ, कन्या से स्त्री बनकर सदियों से समाज की जिम्मेदारी उठाते आ रही हूँ, कभी माँ तो कभी बेटी, कभी माँ तो कभी बेटी, कभी पत्नी का कर्तव्य निभाते आ रही हूँ, कभी माँ तो कभी बेटी, कभी पत्नी का कर्तव्य निभाते आ रही हूँ, और तुम्हारे दिए गए घावों पर मैं स्वयं मरहम लगाते आ रही हूँ। पर मेरी भी एक सीमा है, पर मेरी भी एक सीमा है, अब अपमान का वो घुट मुझे नहीं पीना है। यदि तुम ना संभले है मनुष्य, यदि तुम ना संभले है मनुष्य, तो मैं एक बार फिर दोबारा आऊंगी, यदि तुम ना संभले है मनुष्य, तो मैं एक बार दोबारा आऊंगी, इस बार सीता नहीं, इस बार सीता नहीं, बल्कि रक्त चंडी बनकर आऊंगी। यदि मेरे सम्मान से खेलोगे तो पछताओगे, यदि मेरे सम्मान से खेलोगे तो पछताओगे, और ईश्वर से तुम बचना पाओगे। थैंक यू।
थैंक यू पल्लवी। नेक्स्ट आई एम कॉलिंग रिचा, रिचा बीएससी थर्ड ईयर।
यस मैम।
रिचा हाँ रिचा यू कैन
स्टार्ट। यस मैम हेलो गुड आफ्टरनून।
हेलो रिचा रिचा हाँ
स्टार्ट। यस मैम गुड आफ्टरनून मैम, दिस इज रिचा सिंह फ्रॉम बीएससी नर्सिंग थर्ड ईयर। जिस नारी से लेता है जन्म तू, जिस नारी से लेता है जन्म तू उसी नारी पर अत्याचार करता है, तू क्या संवेदनाएं तुझमें खत्म हो गई हैं? क्या संवेदनाएं तुझमें खत्म हो गई हैं? तू क्यों किसी की पीड़ा महसूस नहीं करता है? कहता है खुद को मर्द और काम ना मर्दों वाले क्यों करता है? कहता है खुद को मर्द और काम ना मर्दों वाले क्यों करता है? तेरे भी घर में माँ बहन, तेरे भी घर में कुछ तुझे और किसी स्त्री में वह रूप क्यों नहीं दिखता है? जिस नारी से लेता है जंतु उसी नारी पर अत्याचार कर।
थैंक यू मैम। ओके थैंक यू। नेक्स्ट आई एम कॉलिंग स्वीटी, स्वीटी सोनी बीएससी फर्स्ट ईयर। हेलो स्वीटी।
यस मैम।
हाँ स्वीटी, स्वीटी यू कैन स्टार्ट। स्वीटी प्लीज प्लीज
The title of my poem is When the worldly things get all the beauty, they tend to live in a world that is unworthy. Face painful reality, fight against wicked principalities, losing your sense of morality. As you are procrastinating about learning your biblical ABCs, when you should be counting all of God's promises like vultures. That is when it begins to spread like a deadly sexually transmitted disease. First a sniffle and a sneeze, then is a cough and a sneeze, then you will barely be able to breathe. Knocking you to your knees, begging God, please let me bring this to be deeper as mercy. Then the history force will begin to tighten space. Then it becomes an infection affects each and every function. Fluid arthritis, this sickness removes color from your life, leaving your light eyes, damaged windows, pupil, and eyes. Being sticky with this ailment with blindness, if you don't take Christ to take the wheel to drive and guide us, this infirmity is very contagious. It will infect your six senses, just like the symbol for the eye of Horus. Because we are individuals, just like sponges, pools, and stone, can get very worried. We need the fishy being, rise a spirit, crying out for help, carrying a cure. The very thought of this illness makes the soul freeze. Once it realizes it has been contracted a spiritually transmitted disease.
Anushi, next, any other else?
Hello, hello, Gopi sir?
Anyone is there still?
No sir, all are done with poetry. We have completed poetry session. Next, we are going to start with posters. Students who prepared poster, be ready with their presentation and I'll call you one by one on your name. Please show your poster and if you want to say a few, if you want to do some presentation, you have 2 minutes to present it. First, I'm calling BSc fourth year, Vaishali. Vaishali, BSc fourth year.
Yes, ma'am.
Vaishali, you Hello? Have 2 minutes to yes, explain ma'am. Whatever yes. you have painted or prepared. And now yeah. you can show your poster.
Yes, ma'am. A very good afternoon, one and all, over present here. Yes. Yes, sir. On this occasion of women's health day, I'm going to present health women health problems after menopause. What is menopause? Menopause is the point when a woman no longer has menstrual periods. It is a normal part of aging that cause that occur early 45 or 50 years of age. During this period, many health changes are there in women's body. Just like, hello?
Hello. Yes, yes, Vishali.
Continue. Is audible?
Yes, yes. Very nice. It's audible.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, there are many changes in women's body. That first one is health diseases. There are many health diseases, even a stroke, osteoporosis, joint pain, muscle pain, and sleep disorder, difficulty in sleeping, and bladder urgency, incontinence, and memory issues like irritation, mood swings, mild depression, and weight gain. These are the conditions that occurs after menopause. And a woman can prevent these all conditions by maintaining a healthy lifestyle, like improved nutrition. After menopause, a woman should take 1200 mg of calcium per day. And regular exercise is very, very important. Improve our health conditions, like prevent the heart diseases, and also help help improve your nutrition. Hello. Yes, ma'am. And regular exercise benefits for heart diseases. Even it helps to improve the mood also. And the women should also involve in rising activity level to avoid the weight losses. Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, thank you, Vishali. Next, we have Akanksha, BSc third year. Akanksha, are you there? Hello, Akanksha.
Yes, sir.
It's visible, sir. It's nice. I think Akanksha is not able to connect her net. So this poster belongs to Akanksha, BSc third year. And she has shown very nicely all the aspects.
Sakshi from BSc third year.
Sakshi, BSc third year. Okay, she's also not here.
Is visible, ma'am?
Yes, sir. Okay, thank you, Sakshi. We are closing our poster session. Next, we will start with a little talk. And this talk is about women's health in different ages. So I'm calling Radha Guru, PNM third year, to start the presentation. Radha Guru.
Yes, ma'am.
Radha, you can start your presentation.
Ma'am, is audible?
Yes.
Yeah, present.
Thank you, ma'am. Women wants to talk about how to make your family healthy, how they take care of their grandparents and in-laws in old days. But why they don't want to talk about themselves? In India, still women ignore their health, and that's why most are battling with deadly disease. So I think this is the best platform to talk about, because we all are working in a community. So I'm sure you will share my talk during your practice. So hello, I'm Radha Gurung, student of JNM third year, want to contribute in women's health and through my talk with you. The theme of International Day of Action for Women's Health 2020 is Our Health, Our Rights, Our Lives. As she grows up, she has to face many problems related to her health and physically changes in her body. Now, I would like to focus some of the problems and health-related issues women face in different age groups. First, at the age group of 10 to 14 years, which is also known as the puberty age. Puberty is the time when all your major organs and body system mature. The physical changes that happens for girls around puberty include changes in body shape, acne problem, breast growth and tenderness, vaginal discharge, unusual hair growth, menstrual cycle, period pain, period irregularity, etc. You may also find some emotional changes occur before the physical changes of puberty, such as experiencing a great sense of self, starting to have a sexual interest into the people, feeling frustrated from when you cannot able to achieve. So, in this age, parents play a major role because parents know their children better. So their first priority is to educate the teenage girl about the reproductive changes in their body, supporting child in physical activity for good physical and mental health. Parents must remember that the changes of puberty are no laughing matter. The rule for parents is there must be no joking, no teasing, no making fun of physical appearance, body changes, or choice of dresses. Secondly, problem faced during the pregnancy at the age group of 22 to 25 years. Pregnancy is a challenging and exciting time for every woman. Pregnancy can mean the beginning of new stages in a woman's life with all the changes that new stages can bring. Women in this stage talks about obvious such as cravings, fatigue, nausea, vomiting, body shape, frequency of micturition, morning sickness, palpitation, gestational hypertension, varicose vein, etc. Like unexpected physical health complication, example, high BP and mental health problems. Many women share their good news with their co-workers, but the truth is that many women are treated unfairly or even fired after revealing the news of their pregnancy, but it is the against law. So support the women about the importance of regular checkup, as well as remove the fear of unknown counseling by supporting the women. Third, at the age group of 35 to 55 years, in this, women face a problem, menopause. During this time, our ovaries get smaller and stop producing the hormone estrogen and progesterone that control the menstrual cycle. For most women, menopause is a natural process, and while the symptoms can be bothersome, it is estrogen disappearing act that causes most of the problems. Problems may include hot flashes, night sweat, sleeping disturbances. Women begin to lose density, mood swing, aggressiveness, vaginal dryness, bodily aches, and pain. So, at this age group of women, they can overcome the problem by advising them to do relaxation and stress reduction technique, healthy lifestyle, about diet, avoid food or beverages with high acid or caffeine content. Eat foods rich in calcium and vitamin D. Eat more foods that are high in phytoestrogen. And at last, exercise regularly. Last, I would like to conclude my speech by some from two lines of quote. Women health needs to be front and center. It's overdue, isn't it? But it needs to be. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Radha. This was really very informative and magnificent. So, successfully we completed all our student side contribution. Last but not least, this time we have to thank all the people who contributed. And for that, I'm calling Ms. Srija. Ms. Srija? Hello? Srija?
Yes.
Hello, Srija.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, yes, completely audible.
Hello.
Go on, Srija.
A warm afternoon to all. I, Sreja Nair, on behalf of Apex College of Nursing, Varanasi, here to deliver a vote of thanks. I would like to thank our Chief Guest, Padma Shri Dr. S. Suramani, to give her precious time and guidance to us. Thank you, ma'am. I would like to thank our Guest of Honor, Dr. Judy, for sharing her thoughts with us. Next, I would like to thank Dr. Blessy Prabha, ma'am, for enlightening us with her knowledge. Thank you, ma'am. I would like to thank our chairman, Dr. S.K. Singh, sir, for his support and encouragement. Also, I would like to thank Dr. Swaroop Patel and Dr. Ankita Patel, director of Super Speciality Hospital, Apex, for their encouragement. Thank you, ma'am and sir. I would like to thank our principal, Apex College of Nursing, Professor R. Johnsy, ma'am, who has always guiding us and help us with her knowledge. Thank you. Next, Principal Apex College of Nursing, Chennai, Mr. Gopi sir, for his support and his. Next, I would like to thank the organizing committee, Mrs. Anita Nandi ma'am, Ms. Anushi ma'am, and Mrs. Shrisha ma'am for their contribution.
Thank you for all the participants who are organized the meeting such a way. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.
Ma'am, you want to say something, ma'am? Principal, ma'am?
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much. We will closing the session.
Hello, Gopi. Yes,